Local Government Minister Raphael Majezi was in the company of his junior minister Victoria Businge Rusoke, as well as a donors delegation from the Lives and Livelihoods Fund, who are in Uganda for a field monitoring activity on selected local economic growth support project sites in Toro region.
We also switch on the other machines.
All right.
Here we go. Where is the crowd?
To the Ntoroko district farmers, the construction of the agro-processing facilities is a dream come true.
The factory will increase household income. The factory will create jobs to the community and youth instead of being job seekers. Generally, our youth will remain here.
Mary Bida, a farmer in Itojo, Karugutu sub-county, says the agro-processing plant has enabled them to double production and add value.
When you sell well-processed maize, it is at a higher price than selling maize which is not processed. And in this, we shall improve on our income. Another thing, our children will get jobs from here.
We are going to get or to have a very big a change, because our children, they are going to put more effort in education because they need to have a job here.
Minister Majezi noted that the establishment of the agro-processing facilities will also increase household incomes for farmers through value addition.
Now when they dry it there on the drying rack, it increases the value to 10,000 shillings a kilo. 10,000 shillings is about $2.5. Simply by drying the bean and you sell it now dry properly. But when it is milled here, properly done and processed, and you export it, we're talking of between $30 and $40 a kilo.
Engineer Paul Kasule, the local economic growth support project coordinator, say that their target is to prepare local governments to become engines of economic growth.
Why we are doing this is that we want the districts to change from just being administrative units, but to also become engines of economic growth.
Improvements to the education of your children and improvements to the quality of your lives. It is really important to us as the donors of the Lives and Livelihoods Funds to really see that we are making a difference to the lives and the livelihoods of ordinary people, of the people of this district.
Report by Roger Sunday for the news.